Tijd voor onze volgende wedstrijd van deze avond. Een oude bekende keert terug op het podium. Hij was finalist op het WK van 2008. Sinds die tijd hebben we niet zo heel veel weer van hem gezien. Maar gisteren was hij prima in zijn wedstrijd tegen Max op. Mag ik een ovatie voor de Karate Kid, Kirk Shepard! En dan de tegenstander van Kirk. Over bekende gezichten gesproken. Deze man die staat al jaren aan de top van de PDC. Tweemaal stond hij in de finale van een WK. In 2012 kroonde hij zichzelf tot European Darts Champion. The Beer to be Feared, The Wizard, Simon Whitlock!
From an unknown love, a woman go and make my love. Can't you hear the thunder? You gotta run, you gotta take cover. Fine bread from a man in Brussels. He was 6'4" and full of muscle. I said, do you speak of my language?
Wisselen we ook van scheidsrechter. Mag ik een applausje voor de scheidsrechter voor de aankomende twee wedstrijden? Kirk Bevins.
We have three Dutch Darts Masters champions on stage tonight, including the three-time defending champion Michael van Gerwen. Kim Huybrechts will be on stage later as well. But right now we've got the 2012 champion Simon Whitlock opening his campaign, seeded four here this weekend. But being a seed seems to count for very little indeed, given the fact we have lost an abundance of them already. Only Rob Cross, Joe Cullen and Daryl Gurney of the top 16 in the field making their way through safely so far. What price another supposed upset here? That said, would it be an upset at all? He's up against the man, of course, who played in the World Championship final as recently as 2008. Kirk Shepard looking to roll back the years once again. Got things going very nicely yesterday, beating Max Hopp by 6-4 in his opening match. Could do with more of the same today. Paul Nicholson, the man who Whitlock beat in 2012. I didn't really want to mention that again, but it just seems such a seamless transition, Paul, with which to bring you in.
I'm absolutely okay with that. It means that I made a final once. Look at the positive side of it.
Not just once.
It wasn't close.
Not just once, Paul.
There was another final in there against Wes Newton at Sindelfingen. But no, that final with Simon Whitlock, we'll touch on that in a second.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg, it's Simon to throw first. Game on!
What I think is important to mention, Rob, is that, yes, we have seen seven seeds go out today, but on top of that, we've got seven seeds who are going home with no ranking points.
Yeah.
That really has made an effect this weekend on the rankings for the European Championship.
Absolutely.
120!
And on the Pro Tour as well. Points on the floor for the Wizard. Simon Whitlock, what can we say about him at this moment in time?
46.
Well, he's a man who's been playing darts constantly for the last few weeks. He's been in Auckland, he went to Melbourne, he went to Perth, and now
140.
He's here in Maastricht. So he shouldn't be rusty at all. If anything, he should be one of the guys that is so used to traveling the length of the globe and playing every week. He should be primed for this.
Yeah, he should be. It's worth noting as well, he averaged almost 108 in a 6-1 win over Kyle Anderson en route to the semi-finals in Melbourne. He has made the semi-finals of one of these Euro Tour events this year as well. That was at the German Darts Masters in Jena in April. but he hasn't advanced beyond round three in any of the six tournaments
Simon
since
Uruguay,
then.
So 145.
He's perhaps overdue a good run this weekend.
No time like the present. Well, he didn't fancy going for the 145. He just fancied laying up
65.
For it.
65.
Unless he hit the bull, he might have gone for a treble 15 and a bullseye just for a showstopper. But at this stage, he'll take the 80.
100.
Kirk has left to finish,
Simon
just in case.
80.
Yeah, just in case Simon Whitlock should fluff his lines here. Let's see if he can pitch this one out. He's going straight for the tops.
Game shot in the first leg. Simon Whitlock.
He's in confidence with that one.
Say
never
Kirk
in doubt.
Throw first.
Never in doubt.
Game on.
That wasn't just confident. That was Jim Walker confident. I'm seeing that a lot more these days, and I think it's not just because he's playing well and he's confident.
52.
He's good at hitting his doubles, but I think it just rubs the other player up the wrong way a little bit and just says, I'm in your face, pal, and this is how I'm going to play today, because it looks like Simon Whitlock's on form.
108!
Quarter-finalist here in the Dutch Darts Masters in Venray, I should say, at the start of 2016. He lost to Mensur Sulevic.
140!
That was one of two quarter-final appearances on the European Tour last year for Simon Whitlock.
We'll go back to the final that we played with each other in a minute.
140!
Just trying to lay him up for a nine darter there. But back in 2012, Simon Whitlock was the best player that week. It's as simple as that. But there was one game that entire week where he was troubled.
99.
He wasn't troubled in the final by me. I played my best stuff in the quarterfinals against Aaron Monk and the semi-final against Wayne Jones, but Simon was brilliant in the final. But there was one game for Simon earlier that week that was the epitome of his form, and he paid Per Larsson
105,
and they went toe-to-toe all the way. It was one of the best games of darts I've ever seen. I really wish it had been streamed or on TV, because it was
75.
That good.
Simon Uruguay, wow. 76.
Simon Whitlock took out 150 in the last leg to beat Per Larsson when he was on a double.
I'm just wondering if there's anyone at the PDC who can dig around for that. Well,
40.
Started off with
Kirk
5
Uruguay,
perfect darts. He's just lost his way slightly here, and Kirk Shepherd has an outside chance of stealing this one. 110 away. Nah, not to be.
46.
Double 18 then.
Simon
Uruguay, Wizard.
36.
Doesn't matter what double it is, he likes it.
Shot on the second leg.
Why not? He does practice his doubles an awful lot.
Third leg, it's Simon to throw first. Game on.
Talking of doubles as well, Shepherd yesterday was pretty effective with 6 from 9. It was the joint best return of the day, along with Jimi Hendrix and Mike De Decker. 6 from 9 in that 6-4 win over Max Hopp.
100.
Strange match actually against Max. He was 3-1 down. Hopp averaged over 100 as well. Two players losing yesterday.
100.
Averages of over 100. Justin Pipe also had 99 and a bit as well.
One thing I looked at with Kirk was his demeanour when he walked on stage, and he just looked a little bit ruffled, a little bit impatient. Whitlock looks very relaxed. It doesn't look like he's got any jet lag from flying in from Perth.
He 58.
Just want to hope that the jet lag doesn't strike in the middle of the game.
He looks very, very settled here into a rhythm, doesn't he?
108!
There is absolutely no stopping him at the moment. And he's down to 41. He's 302 clear, minus these.
98. Simon Uruguay, 41.
Now, Whitlock right now has got a stratospheric average.
Yeah, 121.83.
Game shot on the third leg,
well,
Simon Whitlock. Well,
a very neat and tidy finish too. It's not suffered there at all. His finishing so far, very, very good indeed as well. Perfect, in fact.
59.
Do you get the feeling that Kyle's exploits on the dartboard in the last 24 hours have just spurred Simon on a little bit, as if to say, I'm trying to prove, I don't have to prove who's the Aussie number one, because it's me. And by me, I mean Simon Whitlock.
Well, look at that. There is a gulf of 40 points in the averages already. Shepherd's looking to try and close that deficit, but wow, this is really, really good stuff, especially from Whitlock. He's not going to do it again, is he? He might well do, you know.
177!
Giving Kurt Bevans the opportunity to launch his trademark there. And Whitlock is on for perfection here.
Boy, he's been loving the treble 92. 20 in the last
Simon
couple of legs.
144.
He needs two of them in a row for a shot at double 12 for a 9.
Yeah, he's got the 19s out of the way, but he can't find the treble 20. That's a shame.
96.
It really is a shame.
Kirky require 170.
Could lose the leg. 170 well, coming in from Kirk Shepherd. Seen it there from Bratashki. 1, 2.
Kirk Shepherd
with a karate kick.
Kirk Shepherd
to the solar plexus. A 3-point shot from Kirk Shepherd to Whitlock. Game. Boom, have a bit of that.
Wow. Absolutely illuminating darts, that from Kirk Shepherd.
140.
6 perfect darts for Whitlock to start things off, and Shepherd steals it with a 170 checkout, a 12 dart
125
for the former world championship finalist. Brilliant.
I tweeted just before this game started that the atmosphere here and the practice facilities, it's so conducive
95
to an outstanding play. The statistics don't lie. This game has been flawless so far. People are averaging way over 100 more often than not.
58.
And Whitlock didn't do anything wrong in that leg apart from not hitting a 9 dart leg.
Yeah, Shepherd. Well, that's one of the moments on the European Tour this year that let alone this weekend. I mean, we've seen some really special stuff this weekend, but I think that is one of the moments of 2017, full stop. The figures in this match.
100.
Simon, you're one more checkout for Shepherd. The 170 checkout, 3 from 3 for Whitlock. He's averaging over 120 at the moment as well.
I don't know about Euro, but I'm still recovering from that shot. That was fantastic. Whitlock in control of this leg, though. Unless...
Well, we thought he was in control of the last leg, didn't
precisely.
We? So I'm not really reading anything into that at the moment.
174! Simon Newark, 97.
Well, Simon, I get the feeling that you've got to hit this double top for a 14 dart leg. He'll take a 15. Gets
James
a 15.
Shot on the fifth leg.
This is a proper game of darts, ladies and gentlemen.
Sick leg, it's
put
Kirk
your cup of tea
first.
Down because of Michael Fly. The standard is exemplary.
It is. Look at that. Now 4 from 5, okay, but he took it out on the visit. So as far as I'm concerned, you know, that should not detract from what has been terrific, terrific finishing from both players. Shepherd's approach play at times has been really
43.
Good. I mean, look at that. He's averaging 101 now. His average was down at 83. He has closed that deficit. We highlighted it before. It was 40 points, the gap between the averages. Shepherd has really moved on, but he's still 4-1 down here.
Well, we are, of course, looking at two former world finalists.
Yep.
We mentioned Kirk, but obviously Simon has too. He's
60.
Been in a Lakeside final where he lost to Mark Webster. PDC World Championship final a couple of years after Kirk lost to Taylor. Didn't disgrace himself in that final at all.
76.
He, in fact, had a 170 checkout in that final, Simon Whitlock, as well as about 999,000 others that he's hit along his career.
44.
Seeing genuine fits of anger from Kirk Shepherd with some of the darts he's throwing, because he knows that the standard that they're throwing at right now, he can't afford any mistakes.
94. Kirky require 138.
This is probably the only leg in the match where he's had a big cushion. He's got to take advantage of this with double 12.
140.
Well, this is Shepherd's leg to lose. You think Shepherd will be surprised at how well Whitlock's playing here?
65.
Probably not.
Kirky McGuire, 24.
We're coming into a time of the year where Whitlock usually does play well.
Yeah. We've talked about this time and time again this weekend.
Kirk
a number of players who had a really productive
Seven
leg,
it's Simon to throw first.
We saw him just a few moments ago. He had a very good time of it 12 months ago, and Whitlock is certainly another one. He had a very, very good time, but he claimed his first PDC title in over 2 years. in Players' Championship 18 and Players' Championship 19 as well. And once again, he has started off with a 180 here.
96.
Well, if this is what the guys are going to deliver for the rest of the weekend, I'm really looking forward to working with yourself and Dan. The standard today has 58. Been one of the best days I've seen on the European Tour in all my time, either playing or watching it. It's been that good.
Yeah.
96.
And the fact that some of the, or the majority of the good stuff has been produced by the non-seeded players as well.
It's a scary prospect, isn't it?
99.
We haven't even had Michael van Gerwen or Peter Wright yet. Gary Anderson's not even here.
And Mentor Cilovic bringing the curtain down later on as well.
139.
Well,
Simon, you require
you mentioned the approach player.
Well, yeah.
That Kirk was flawless.
Kirk Shepherd's scoring tonight has been, you know, very, very good indeed. He is not doing a great deal wrong here. Now, he's taken out 170 already.
64.
That closed the gap to 3-1.
Kirk require 170.
This would close the gap to 4-3. This is a big moment. Surely he couldn't do it again. No, he can't.
42.
Well, 170 is a rare.
100.
Two 170s a game is like a pink moon. No, Michael van Gerwen has done that before at the UK Open. Double top. Simon Whitlock and a 5-2 advantage.
Took two of them out in the opener.
60.
Can't find one there though.
Kirk Yuguai 100.
And Shepherd is back in the hunt once again here. Six 180s in this match. Five of them for Whitlock.
Another one of those.
Ooh.
Went next door. He fancied it. It was a great lie for him.
Would have left double 10, but he's just had to try and get himself
96.
Back on track.
I mean, you require 40.
So Whitlock has another opportunity at tops. He's been given a bit of a reprieve here. He can't afford to dwell too much longer on this.
No score.
Well, tops in the opener.
Kirk Yuguai 32.
Five darts at tops. He's missed them all.
Biggest time of the match for Kirk Shepherd.
Takes on it. The seventh leg.
It's a totally Kirk different match now.
Eight leg is
it
Kirk
could have been so
first.
Different.
Game on.
But because Whitlock has missed a few darts at doubles, we're back on throw. Game on, ladies and gentlemen. And quite frankly, because this game's so good, I don't want it to end.
Yeah.
180.
I really do. It's worthy of going all the way to 11 legs. We've seen plenty of those this weekend as well. Matches that all the way. And there are signs here that this one could go to 11 legs as well.
99.
I spoke to Kirk last night after his victory and said, well played, mate. One bit of advice, just zip up your shirt a bit. Don't want to look like Ted Hankey too much. And he's taken my advice. So thanks, Kirk. But I did play Kirk earlier this year in European qualifying.
135.
In a preliminary game, and he blew me away. Played me in Milton Keynes, and he was irresistible. It said to me that he has definitely got a lot to offer the game still.
87.
And tonight is proof, because after nine, he's on 87.
Game shot on the eighth leg, Kirk Shepherd.
The finishing is still
ninth
very,
leg is
very
Simon
strong
to throw
indeed,
first.
Isn't it?
Game on.
It's just carried on where he left off yesterday. Just while we were talking about the prospects of this match going to 11 legs, that was very far from being the case in their previous two encounters.
108!
Whitlock rattled in a much needed 180. Whitlock winning their two previous meetings, both in 2011, both by 6-0. One in the Players' Championship, one in the UK Open qualifiers.
100!
So this is not reflective of what has gone before, but that was 6 years ago.
I think we may be witnessing
another 180 potential.
180!
Well, I'm not going to finish what I was going to say, because there's something more important about to happen, potentially. This is his second chance at the big one.
Simon, you require 141.
Dare we believe, dare we dream.
I believe.
Dare we.
He's going the John Law route. Oh, he's going his own route.
Now, some of the crowd think that first dart was in. It's
94.
Not.
Oh, 57. That would have left the 84. I guarantee he would have gone treble 16 for double 18. And Ross Smith has tweeted saying that
120
if he go for double 18.
Simon Yuguai 47.
It's not going to be in this leg. Maybe in the next few games. Dare to dream. Double 16.
Game shot.
Perfect.
The ninth leg.
What a game of darts we are witnessing.
10th leg, it's Kirk to throw first. Game on.
It's just high quality, high octane. Shepherd looked to be out of things at 4-1 down, but he's clawed his way back in with some pretty spectacular stuff. Back-to-back 11 dart legs as well, a 12 dart leg early on, which included that 170 checkout in a leg in which Whitlock had hit six perfect darts. Twice he's done that this evening now. He's had five perfect darts as well.
62.
Yeah, what I was going to say in the last leg about Kirk Shepherd was that maybe we're witnessing a little bit of a resurgence from Kirk, so we can have version two of Kirk Shepherd.
Which would be great to see.
It would, because the guy's got talent. He's got
140.
A crazy personality, a sense of humour that sometimes has to be censored, but at the same time, he's a great player. And I think he's done a lot of growing up in the
39.
Last few years. He's made some mistakes. He's admitted those mistakes, and now he's ready to be the dart player that he always should have been.
Well, his only previous appearance in Europe this year was a disappointing one. It was very short-lived in Hildesheim, losing to Richie Corner 6-2.
121.
It's been a much more impressive showing this time around, even if he goes on to lose this match. And who's to say he won't? He's got work to do here, though.
83.
And he could have well done without that as well.
Well, two darts that signify the small margins of this game. Disappointment on the third dart for both guys, but it's Whitlock who has the chance to
99.
Put this whole thing away, and he will want to as quick as possible. He won't want to give any more chances to Karate Kid.
Might be a chance here for him, though. 97-08.
139.
Trying to leave himself top.
Simon, you require 60.
Whitlock, 60 points away then from a place in the last 16. Two darts at tops. He missed five cracks at darts at tops earlier on. That's pitched him very awkwardly indeed. He's had to head over to double 10 instead.
40.
And Kirk Shepherd breathes
Kirk
again.
Kirk, you require 78.
He breathes. He has a chance to take us all the way. And the neutral people will definitely want to see an 11th leg with more drama. In order for that to happen, he's got to take this with double 12. What a great first dart.
Lovely. Takes a moment as well here. Ooh, somewhere inside, double six to take us into an 11th and final
66.
Leg. And Simon Whitlock is given another
20.
Opportunity. This time it's at double 10. And this time he's got three darts in hand. And
in
this
shot.
Time he makes no
match.
Mistake whatsoever.
Simon Whitlock.
Simon Whitlock comes out on top in, for me, the highest quality match of the weekend so far. There could be more to come, but where do you begin summing that one up? Simon Whitlock with an average of around about 102. Kirk Shepherd far from disgraced as well, catching the eye with some lovely finishing once again and a 170 checkout. Whitlock threatened the nine darter on three occasions in there too. He won't really care about that. It's job done. Whitlock goes through to the last 16. He'll face Robert Owen as well for a place in the quarterfinals. And the Wizard is back in business. He was threatening this in Melbourne, where he made the semi-finals, where he battered Kyle Anderson. And he's just reminded us all there is more than one Australian in this particular tournament. Champion of 2012, who knows, could be the champion of 2017. Whitlock goes through and he's all smiles. We'll hear from him now.
Simon, congratulations. 7-180s. That was nearly a flawless game.
Yeah, I missed a few doubles and hit a few bad shots, but yeah, very happy with that. You know, on a couple of nine darters, so I'm getting close again.
Take us back to that one leg. You go 180, 177, I think. You missed the nine darter, and then Kirk goes out on 170. What were you thinking at that time?
I know, it's like a great leg. You know, just take my hat off. I had to win in nine darts that leg, so, you know, I just have to let it go and then concentrate on the next leg. But you know what, Kirk played amazing then. It's the best I've seen him play for a long, long time, and hats off to him.
You're playing better and better of late, at least on the floor tournaments. You're getting better on the big stages as well, but what does it do to lift the title?
Yeah, you know what? I'm getting better every game. You know what? I'm here to win again. You know, I feel as though I can win, and that's the important thing.
And ladies and gentlemen, he has won before on this stage, because in 2012 he was the Dutch Darts Master. Morgen zien we hem terug, the Wizard, Simon Whitlock.